Don't easily forget what people do for you. What you are looking for is already on the head of somebody. I am a full subscriber of honor. If I see people talking against things that are higher than me, I keep quiet sadly. They may have made errors, but it's not my job to correct them. Never in your lifetime speak against anybody that has laid hands on you. Never. The best language for such people is silence. If you know that what will come out of your mouth will not be good, keep quiet. Otherwise, your blessing tomorrow is at stake. The Bible said, without any contradiction, the lesser is blessed by the greater. It is possible you will never drive a Land Cruiser if you attack the one driving now. There are days that you have to sit back and look at the transitions of your life. At every junction, who was responsible for the next transition? Watch that and begin to honor them. It doesn't matter their situation in life. Honor them. He said, we were 32 pastors. And every day you will go and the pastors are talking in, na papa, na say na, this and that. And he said they were always talking. And anytime he finds them talking, he said he will withdraw. And this was the things he told me. He said, I remember that my first aeroplane I sat in, it was this man that paid the ticket. I can't speak against him. It doesn't matter what he's doing in life. I can't speak against him. He said that out of the 32, he's the only one standing. All of them are scattered. When you find the nakedness of Noah, keep quiet. Even in his drunkenness, he will curse you and it will come to pass. Some of you have fought things that are too high. Your mother that carried you 9 months, you stood and insulted her. Go and lie down, hold her leg and ask her of anything she needs in life. Do it for her. Otherwise, you will leave this earth in pain. If you want to check out how it is, go to a labor ward and see the pain in bringing a child out. Go back and check the kind of work your father did to sustain the family. Most of our fathers are sick today because of the stress they went through when they were young in trying to work to take care of the family. And then today you sit back and you can speak anyhow against them and you go. You have touched your future by one statement. You are said, God, far be it, far be it. Whether present or past, that I will say anything that is directly against the one that gave birth to me. Far, far. I may not like something, but I can only entreat. How many of us have destroyed the future even before we enter, and you are clapping 2022, I will be blessed. That is how come you clap 2020 that you will be blessed, but 2021 is ending, nothing has happened. Go back to honor. There are people you have joked with, and because of them, blessing is hanging on your head. You have forgotten when you didn't have food to eat, and you were crying to God, and somebody came and gave you his last money, and he left. Today, you are attacking that person. One time, God told the children of Israel, beware lest you forget. You forget where you are coming from. So beware. He never said, honor your father, your good father and mother. Honor your perfect father and mother. Honor them so that your days will be long. Joke with them and you may never see long days. I got married to my wife. I told my wife, these people are untouchable in our lives. What they have done, even if they don't do anything for us again, they are finished. They have finished their work. We and our generations will honor them to the end. They are finished. Today they can come, attack, insult, fight, shoot. They have finished. There are some of you, the only time you honor a human being, the only time you honor a human being is when he is carrying something to give you. The moment you take it, you forget it. And you turn back like a dog to attack them again. Some of you should live here and send somebody you don't care a message. Send them a message and say, I love you, sir. God used you. There are people I pick a phone to open an employment door for them. The moment they got the job, they have stopped church. They don't even pick calls. They don't reply text message because now they have a job. Oh, how we are destroying the future because we don't understand certain structures that God has placed in the kingdom. Nobody will rise outside honor. You must pass through something. When I came here, God told me, Go and honor Reverend Fifi. Go and honor him. Go and honor him. Because I'm a young boy, vibrant. So I've come. We are coming to do the prayer. And foolishly, as some people talk, we are the vibrant ones. We are coming to pray. We are coming to prophesy. We will take the area. That is how we would have closed our church long time. But by honor. If they are insulting somebody who has done something for you, fight them or walk away. There are some people who even forget to say thank you. Do you know the divine orchestrations that goes on before a human being will remember you and do something for you? Many people's future has been hijacked, literally hijacked by dishonor. You are forgotten so quickly. Somebody who led you in the way of God, today you see him as a small boy, a small girl. You were there when God gave me that grace. The best you can do is to honor to get it. There is nothing physical about this kingdom. Nothing is physical. The next thing God will give you, he will take it from somebody here and give it to you. The Bible said he took the spirit upon Moses and distributed it to 70 elders. Be careful who you dishonor in this life. If you really want to be blessed, be careful. One time Jude was warning the Jews and he told them that you people speak against things that are higher than you. He said that when Michael met Lucifer, the devil, Satan, he said he could not rain any rebuke on him. All that he said, the Lord rebuked him. He directed the devil to Jesus and he stood aside. And Jude said that you people have been talking and you don't know what you are talking about. This week a young boy ran to me. He is having strange diseases and his mother too is dying at the same time. Then he ran to me and I wanted to fish into the situation. That was when I realized that he dishonored his pastor. And he didn't, it was not peaceful. He just walked away and said so many things. The woman of God is not anointed. He can't take him far. He can't do that. But he was polishing the words to me. So I told him, give me the number of your woman of God. Let me call. So immediately I took a phone here and I called the woman. And thanks be to God, the woman knew me. So we started talking. And the woman started telling me the words the boy said to people. Meanwhile, he was living in the woman's house. The woman was feeding him. And he was a pastor in the church. The woman bought him a car. Yet he said that his life is stagnant because of the woman. He won't be able to go far. I told the woman of God, woman of God, if I keep this young man in Grace Mountain, he will die. You need to take him back. He said, even our superintendent has come to speak that I should take him back. I've decided not to. I pleaded with him. And he said, I don't know why, but because of you, I'll take him back. And listen, the same day, the young man went to his head, the church, they were doing program. The woman called the young man out, anointed him, restored him, and allowed him to sing again. I sent the young man a message. I said, your life has escaped. Your life has escaped. You would have died. The people that leave other men of God and there is no repercussion are people that evil has been done to them. But I told him that if God should judge the matter now, and look into my eyes, you have done the woman evil. He said, Papa, it's true. I don't know what came from me. Some of you have done so much hurt and evil. The people that held your hands to introduce you to things, today you have turned your back. You have to make amends. There's a blessing ahead of you that you have to do something about it. The people you have taken for granted, go back and take good care of them. Honor will take you far. Some of you are missing the road already. You have done things and said things that is hijacking a blessing in your life. I can't afford to miss my destiny because of one easy easy mistake, error. Anybody that I know is greater than me. No thought, no thought. That thought is not permitted. It can't flash my mind. Anybody that is on top, that thought will never, that the person has made a mistake, that the person is doing wrong, that thought cannot come. As far as I live, as far as I live, anybody I call a father, there is nothing the person says who, that I won't catch in the air. It must not fall, and it will be done as it is. Let a Ghanaian young boy get a job right now, young girl get a job right now, he starts to change the way he talks. People are committed in church until they start taking salary. They begin to say blasphemous stuff. Don't have honor for grace. All this is, I'm saying, there are people who don't merit such honor. Forget about it. There are men of God, women of God, who don't really merit anything like honor. Talking about genuity of God's work and grace. I pray for somebody here. I don't know where your life has gotten to now. I pray for the spirit of goodness and the spirit of honor to invade our hearts right now. Wherever you are, just lift up that holy hands.